A lot of people are moving out of the West Coast areas and moving inwards towards Eastern Washington, Northern Idaho, Southern Idaho. And today we are going to be looking at the three most expensive neighborhoods in East Washington. So stick around. Guys, welcome to Living Life in East Washington. My name is Trent, this is Kevin, and today we are talking about the three most expensive neighborhoods in East Washington. If this is something that you're interested in learning more about, make sure you hit that subscribe button, tap the notification bell so every time we come out with a new video, you get notified. And if this is something that you're interested in doing, getting out of the West Coast states and moving inland, let us know. We can definitely help you get set up here. Give us a call on that number. Shoot us a text or an email. Can't help you unless you reach out. And we love helping people get moved here because it's a gorgeous place to live.
Absolutely.
So right now we are standing on Legacy Ridge in Liberty Lake. As you can see behind me, there are some gorgeous, massive homes. If I turn you around real quick, you have a view of the entire Liberty Lake area. To our right, south of us, is Liberty Lake with Liberty Lake Trail. Now, what makes this place so stinking desirable is a lot of the homes here are newly built or built in the 90s and updated. They're very spacious, very nice. It's a golfing community. So a lot of people who like to golf like living here because you have three golf courses right in the immediate area. And local laws allow you to drive your golf cart anywhere you want within city limits, which
that's
is
pretty cool.
It's pretty awesome. So yeah. Kevin, tell us about the homes here.
I mean, we've got homes, you know, median price range for Liberty Lake in general is $512,000. Here at Legacy Hills, gated community up on top where you've got views of everything, anywhere from about $700,000 to $1.3, $1.4 million in this development. And it's just spectacular up here. So if you want to have views of Mount Spokane, the lake, and everywhere around you, this is a great spot right here.
Now, this is an awesome neighborhood for being on the hill, but you also have houses around the lake that have boat slips that are really large, very gorgeous. Can you tell us anything about those?
You know, Liberty Lake is a nice, small, you know, to medium-sized lake. So, you know, nice little runabout ski boat works well there. And you've got hiking trails all around it that go up to waterfalls. So it's just a really neat feature to have right in your community within walking distance of most of the neighborhoods here.
Now, another part of living in Liberty Lake and making it one of the most expensive neighborhoods in East Washington is everything is really conveniently placed. For those who like to go over into North Idaho to go to the lakes and trails over there, you're only 5 minutes across the state line and you're in Idaho. You're 15 minutes from Coeur d'Alene and you're about 40 minutes from the international airport. And this neighborhood, I mean, I've lived in a lot of different places in this area, and Liberty Lake has always been kind of the gem between Spokane and North Idaho. It's really, really well maintained. There's no areas here where it's kind of the lower end area. All of it is really nice and really gorgeous. And everybody's very tight knit. You say hi to your neighbors, you get to know everybody. And even just going to the grocery store, the crime rate down here is super low. It's just a really, really friendly place to live.
Great places to work. You've got Huntwood cabinets and a bunch of high tech industry located in the business corridor along the freeway. So plenty of jobs. Tech industry jobs and the like, as well as manufacturing jobs.
Now, if you were down in Southern California, LA, Santa Barbara area, these are very similar homes to there, but the price is so much different. Where down there you're paying, you know, $2 million, $3 million for a home with a view like this, and here you're paying between $600,000, $1.3 million. So even though for locals that seems like a very out of reach, expensive range, for somebody that's moving out of, or in from out of town, it's actually quite affordable, as you'll see.
Yeah, we've got a lot of, these are well-maintained HOA neighborhoods, so everybody keeps their homes up to par, and a lot of good amenities that come with these planned developments as well.
So coming at you with the next most expensive neighborhood, we are up here in 5 Mile, which is in the North Spokane area. Kevin, what are homes costing in this area?
Well, our medium home price range is $420,000, but along the edges of the prairie where you have some amazing views, both back west and east, you're gonna be $700,000-$900,000 homes. You know, there's several multi-million dollar homes up here, but for the most part, you're gonna be $700,000-$800,000 for some of these in this planned developments up here.
Okay, and as you can see, the house behind us, it's a nice house, but why you're paying that cost, why it's one of the most expensive neighborhoods, is because of the views that you get up here. They are absolutely gorgeous, super panoramic, expansive. Plus, even though you're still very much so in Spokane, you are kind of separated apart. You're on, you know, 5 Mile is on a hill, and so it's very much feels different than the rest of Spokane.
Yeah, you're geographically separated from the rest of the area around you. So it kind of elevates itself, and up on the prairie, they've built a lot of new planned developments and have some nice parks and new schools and stuff up here. So it kind of separates itself from the rest of North Spokane.
Absolutely. And so in my early 20s, I've talked about being a cable technician in some of my other videos, and I've been in a lot of these homes. In fact, I probably installed a lot of the cable when these homes were first built. And I can tell you a lot of them are absolutely gorgeous. They have custom cabinets, custom countertops. I mean, they're built to match the price, absolutely. And when you get a home up here, I've never met anybody who went, didn't feel like the value was there.
Yeah, yeah. A buddy of mine, Mike Genova's got a home that was featured in Better Homes and Garden, and it's a baller home. So there's some nice homes up here.
All right, guys, we are at our last neighborhood, the most expensive neighborhood in the east side of Washington. We are up here on the South Hill, specifically on Sumner and Grand. And over here, you are basically have mansions, and there's several famous people that live here, like John Stockton, who played for the Utah Jazz. You have Stu Eady, who helped create ESPN. And the homes up here, Kevin, how much do they range from?
You know, median home prices are like $420,000, but you know, you get along the edge of the South Hill overlooking downtown, and you start getting $800,000, $900,000, over $1 million historic mansions, you know, mansions that were built by the founders of Spokane, and now owned by a lot of the doctors and stuff that work just blocks away at that Sacred Heart and Deaconess Medical Centers.
Yeah, but once you get inside some of the homes, like particularly this one that I have the privilege of filming a couple of years ago, I'll show you guys some clips. But once you get inside, you realize why they are some of the most expensive houses, because a lot of them have been maintained. They've kept their antique nature. They've been upgraded on some parts, but a lot of times the people who own them and have upgraded them have kept basically the historic value. So you still—
Butler pantries.
Yeah.
Dumb waiters, you know.
Yeah. You still feel like you're in a historic home, but they've been updated. So, you know, better heating and probably gas stoves and things like that. But this part of the South Hill is really beautiful. If you head further south, you get into farmland. It's really, really gorgeous up there. There's also kind of its own community. So even though you're very much so in Spokane, it's its own separate area. You are about 15 minutes from the arena that has major acts when it's not COVID season, like Tool, Jim Gaffigan, Metallica. I've seen all them there. They do monster truck rallies. You're about 10 minutes away from Gonzaga University, which is a very well-known school. And then you have the medical community here, which is really well known. You have Deaconess, Sacred Heart. So anyone who is in retirement age, this is a really great place to live because medical is so close. So what else can you tell us about this place?
Just gorgeous, sought after area because of its convenience and historic nature. Just everybody loves the character of the homes up here because there is not one home that is like the next. These homes were built in an era where each home was customly built. So historic mansions and some just amazing history here.
Awesome. Well, guys, I'm freezing. It's like 30 degrees and starting to snow. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you haven't yet, please hit that subscribe button. Make sure you tap the notification bell because we're going to come out with these videos every single week. And if you are considering moving to East Washington, please make sure you give us a call. Kevin is my guy. He's the realtor. He can help you get all set up. He knows his stuff. I am just the marketing guy. I do real estate over on the Idaho side, but we can get you all set up. Make sure you give us a call, shoot us an email or a text, and we will see you on the next video. Bye.
Thanks.